Canada set to increase its military presence in the Indo-Pacific region amid tensions between the Philippines and China. This story and more from our North America Bureau correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
We begin in New York, where former Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo finally got to address her PhilAm supporters. Robredo answered questions as to why there was no complaint filed, despite a number of unanswered questions and concerns regarding the May presidential election.
It would have been a consolation for everyone. Kung may kaso ipafile, because we could hold on to it. Pero we felt that it would be unfair to the supporters to let you keep on hoping on something that's not there. Hindi ko po sinasabing walang dayaan na nangyari. Ang sinasabi ko lang, walang nakita. Walang nakita yung ating mga teams.
Moving forward, Robredo stressed the role of people in holding those in power accountable.
For good governance to thrive, there should be at least three factors. Number one is accountability of government officials. Number two is transparency. Pero yung third na pinakamalaki, talagang people empowerment.
Let's go to Vancouver, where a virtual town hall hosted by Filipino-Canadian Member of Parliament Rechi Valdez and Canadian officials gave members of the Filipino community a broad outline of the country's new Indo-Pacific strategy. This aims to invest $2.3 billion over the next 5 years in the area that is seen as the world's next fastest-growing region. Along with increased trade with the 40 Indo-Pacific countries, Canada also plans to beef up its military presence in the region and invest in cybersecurity. Canadian officials said they are closely watching the developments in the Philippines' ongoing territorial dispute with China in the West Philippine Sea, as well as the tensions between China and other Indo-Pacific countries.
What we will do is try to bring partners to the table to say these are our disputes that need to be solved diplomatically and can't be done by aggression.
And finally, the Filipino Arts and Cinema International, or FACINE, a nonprofit media arts organization, is celebrating its recent film festival and its impact on the community through the years.
We are the longest-running Filipino film festival outside of the Philippines and within the United States. It's been very historical for us to now move into our 30th birthday. And in doing so, our theme this year was focused on revision.
FACINE features thought-provoking full-length and short films that bravely tackle pressing Filipino issues and concerns.
The theme now, revision, is very much timely as with the current administration that we have. And it's a very good lineup of films we have this year. There's one film about a kid who grew up in the camps. It's about the martial law era. And then there's another short film called Never Forget by Ida Anita Del Mundo. And it stars my daughter, Mara Lopez, by the way, and it's about the Escalante massacres during martial law.
And those are the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.